Good evening, this is Sheshachalam from Astro Guide Mysore. Today we are going into the subject of Dvikala Trayoga and its combinations. I have written on the board one most important combination, that is of Jupiter and Venus. And we can see that I have written some number of house numbers. That is, when Jupiter and Venus are conjunct in the sense that they are both within, let us say, 8 or 10 degrees. And then they are placed in the 2nd, 5th, 7th, 9th and the 12th from the ascendant, then there is a chance, I am not telling it's for surety, there is a chance that Dvikalatra Yoga will happen, that is second marriage might happen. So once again, you need to see my previous video to understand this, because if the 7th house is strong and strong enough and stable enough, then where will there be a question of Dvikalatra Yoga at all? So, if the 7th house is weak, it is, you know, the 7th lord is retrograde, debilitated or placed along with, you know, malefic planets, then there is a chance that the 7th house becomes weaker than the 9th house. And if the combination of, you know, these combinations, planetary combinations are there in the chart, it is also known as the Dvi Guru Yoga, then we get that particular chart has a tendency to get into a second marriage. So let me go through some combinations of Dvikalatra Yoga. I'll get to the combinations. Before that, when you see, go through Brihat Parashara Hora Shastra, Brihat Jataka Varahamira, there you can see that the more number of planets associated with the 7th lord, that number of spouses. It's a very simple, formulae. And that formula is very simple, telling that the number of planets associated with the 7th house, you will have to count the number of spouses. That doesn't happen in actual practice, because I have tested that particular thing in many charts. It doesn't happen. It doesn't happen that if somebody has 4 planets in the 7th house along with the 7th lord, that doesn't mean that they will marry 4 times. The point here to be understood, the intention behind that particular sentence in those classic books is that the affliction of the 7th lord, that is, any combination of planet along with the 7th lord is an affliction to marriage. Let me give you an example to this. I am giving the same example here. So I will take the most simplest of the lagnas, that is Mesha Lagna, for which the 7th lord becomes Venus. And if I put both Jupiter and Venus in the 7th house, this constitutes to a very strong Dvikalatra Yoga, because Jupiter is also the 9th lord. 9th lord in the 7th house has a strong, aspect over the ascendant, and so it will play its role in its dasha and its sub periods also. So this is also one sort of a Dvikalatra Yoga. So if we go to the let me take Mithuna ascendant, and once again you can see that Jupiter becomes the 7th lord, and when the 7th lord is posited, let us say, in the 11th house, 7th lord is in the 11th house, fine, but the planets associated with the 7th lord is of high importance. So if I have Mars here, this is not going to amount to Dvikalatra Yoga. People should very clearly understand that this gives rise to a very big Raja Yoga. And because the 7th lord is aspecting the 7th house, there is no Dvikalatra Yoga here. Now I am going to add another planet there, and I'll spoil this particular combination, and I will introduce the Dvikalatra Yoga here. I have added Saturn here. So what is Saturn? Saturn is the 9th lord from Gemini. The 9th lord getting associated with the 7th lord and another planet will give a very strong thrust to the second marriage. And this thrust will become all more stronger if either of Jupiter or Saturn is retrograde. I am not telling both have to be retrograde. I have seen in many cases that when the 7th lord and the 9th lord both are retrograde, the person will peacefully be in one marriage. I have seen that in many cases. So it is not that both are retrograde and it will 100% or surety is there that it will happen. So let us take that Jupiter alone is retro and Saturn and Mars. This is a very strong combination, but a malefic combination for marriage. It's a good combination for professional success, as this is the 11th house. And you can see that Nichabanga Raja Yoga is a kind of Nichabanga Raja Yoga has happened, because Saturn is deprecated, but the dispositor of Saturn is in its own house, that is Mars. So let me go to another combination, and we can go through thousands of combinations. I am just giving you some combinations so that you can verify when you are doing analysis of charts. It will be good for you to understand this particular combination of the seventh lord. This is the importance of in this Dvikratra Yoga combinations. I am giving you combinations only of the seventh lord as on date. So I'll keep giving. I have made my mind that I will finish this Dvikratra Yoga in complete detail and then move on to another subject. Let us go to the subject of the disturbed marriage, which I actually did only one video and I did not go ahead with that. I will do that once again with the Papakartari Yogas and many other things. So here it is importance or the role of the seventh lord. I am not talking about the seventh house here, please. Don't get carried away with the seventh house. Seventh house combinations are once again many. Hundreds and thousands of combinations are there. I am just talking about the importance or the role of the seventh lord in second marriage. This is very important, because if the seventh lord is placed along with her very good benefics, once again it will become a malefic combination for the marriage. You know, let us take it in the other way. If the seventh lord is not associated with any planet, it is purely placed in the seventh house, and because it's in its own house, it will not give marriage at all. This is the funniest thing which happens. Or it will delay the marriage to a very long time. So people will get married after 35 or 40, 45 also. If there is no affliction, the marriage is delayed. So that means the planets themselves are telling that, a pure planet is trying to tell that, why do you want to get married and simply spoil your life? So that's what I told yesterday in my video, that marriage means mar I age, that is, I spoil my youth. So that means when planets are associated, you have more associations with the opposite gender or the person whom you would fall in love with or you would get attracted to. There are many charts with me where the like genders also get attracted. So it is there. It's a common thing now. So people earlier days, they were not speaking about it. They were not open about it. Now I have a lot of clients with me itself who openly talk that, they all these LGBT things, they openly talk about it. There is nothing to hide about it. And please try to understand, there is no shame about it. People have to be proud to openly talk about relationships, whatever the relationship might be. It is between two souls. It is not between bodies. If people are so, thinking so low that they always think about the physical body and its attraction, then I think marriage has no value there. So marriage means, as I said, the five major points are to be associated: the physical, emotional, psychological, spiritual and intellectual. So in that, if people are only attached to the physical thing, that means I think they don't know what a marriage is. So the importance of the seventh lord. Let me go to one more example and then see whether I can do two more. That is two more from now. So I am taking a very conflicting ascendant. These two ascendants are called conflicting ascendants because you get Saturn as the seventh lord. So let us put Saturn here. Let us put Saturn here. Let it be in its own house. No affliction. No affliction. But is well placed in the seventh house. And if this Saturn is retrograde, now comes the difficult part. Saturn, when it becomes retrograde in its Moola Trikona Sthana, this is its Moola Trikona house. That is, it's a very strong placement for Saturn, and it has given rise to a super duper Sasa Yoga. And sometimes people keep asking me that whether Sasa Yoga really works for Leo. It is a very tough thing to answer, because I have seen lot number of charts. It works, but with lot of challenges, and that person will not be happy at all with that Sasa Yoga. Many people are there with Malavya Yoga, and they keep asking me, did my Venus give me Malavya Yoga? I have never seen anything in the Venus Dasha. And many people are having Hamsa Yoga in their chart, and they have not gone through the happiness of Hamsa Yoga at all. So these things happen, and these are all exceptions of yogas. Exceptions and cancellations and transformations of yoga also is a very big subject. Anyway, as time progresses, I will be giving clarity in each subject. Here I am giving you clarity on a Sasa Yoga where Saturn is retro and it is the 7th house. The 7th lord in the 7th house, unafflicted Saturn, and it is retrograde. This will give a very different perspective on marriage, and in most of the cases, the person will not be married at all. It will be unmarried. So, now, with this Saturn here, my theory, I am trying to now stress the theory here. What if there is a strong Mars in the 9th house, along with the planet of, the planet of the 5th house, the Lord of the 5th house, which is called as the Lord of the House of Romance, Jupiter, and the Lord of Romance itself, Venus. Here it first itself, there is a very strong negativity that the native does not want to get married. There is a phobia, there is a difficulty in accepting a relationship. But the funny part is, after quite number of years, let us say at the age of 45 or 50, the person would fall in love, or he or she would like somebody, you know. It's not an infatuation or a crush which happens at 45, 50. It is not even a calculated marriage at all. It is for companionship. They will know each other, but there would, many times there would not be any, you know, regular things what usually people go through marriage. But there would be more of an intellectual and a spiritual requirement which will actually make a person go through a marriage. But here it is the first marriage. But because of the delay, we can call it that it is a delayed first marriage, which is because of the stress of the 9th house. So this is not to be taken as a second marriage, but we can call it as a very highly delayed first marriage. So we can also see these types of transformations and changes when there is a strong 5th house, negative in the 5th house, and there is a strong 7th house. The children also happen after, let us say, multiple abortions, multiple difficulties of conceiving, and then at last after somewhere 38 years or 40 years, the lady will conceive. So these things happen. I'll come to those points when I talk about those topics. So here, this is a very, very difficult thing to actually understand, but still I have not gone into the D9, I have not done the D7 so for children, or the D9 for marriage. I am just doing it on the surface, because this is the basic level. I am not going to the detailed chart analysis at all. So let us go into one more. I think I have time for one more. I will just do one more ascendant, and then we will see what we can do about it. So let us take another ascendant. Okay. This is a difficult ascendant for marriage. Sagittarius. Because Sagittarius, we always give a lot of weightage and respect for Sagittarius ascendant. Why? Because these people are having utmost patience. As the Pisceans, Sagittarius also have a lot of patience. They have endurance, the power of endurance. They can take a lot of pain even they are, going through life. So we call them people with a lot of endurance. The you know, exact opposite. The more careless, cunning, fast-witted and calculative, you know, not always cunning. So if people are in Gemini, please don't get offended that I am calling you cunning. But yes, these people can manipulate, they can think fast and they can understand and adjust very fast. This is an adapt, they adapt very fast to the situation. They adapt not to for the betterment of the situation, they adapt for betterment of self. So this is a selfish Rashi. When compared to most of the other Rashis, this is a selfish Rashi and this is a selfless Rashi. So these are all opposites. I can explain each Rashi like that, but this is a selfless Rashi and this is a selfish Rashi. So the point here, the difficulty happens when we have a strong positive planet sitting here and the seventh Lord going to the 12th house or going to the 8th house, the person will go through a Dvikalatra Yoga. Like for example, let us say this might be the combination. So this shows a very strong combination for Dvikalatra Yoga, as the 9th house is super duper strong now and the 7th house is very weak, because here Venus is a malefic planet for this ascendant. 6th and 11th Lord, prime malefic, and sitting in the 7th house, it will destroy that house. And the 7th Lord going to the 8th house along with the 8th Lord. So this combination is very bad when compared to this beautiful combination of Sun in the 9th house. So I have seen some cases with these types of combinations that the first marriage would break, but it will not get divorced, mind it. It will break by separation, by distance, maybe for a few years, let's say around 2 or 5 years. And then again, the same two people, the couple become one and they again start living. So this happens when the 8th Lord and the 8th house gets mixed up with the 7th Lord. But not always, you know, when the 8th house or the 8th Lord gets mixed up with the 7th house, that it ends up in a divorce. There might be differences, misunderstanding, separation because of depression. People might go, you know, they might separate and go back to their parents' houses. These things happen nowadays. But we need to understand the chart in depth to understand whether they can come back and again, you know, reconcile. I have had clients who have reconciled. So nothing's wrong about it. So we need to understand whether the reconciliation can happen before we should pronounce a divorce for the charts. So thank you very much for today's class. I hope I have given some clarity on the combinations for Dvikalatra Yoga. I'll carry on with the combinations along with live charts also. So I think a week long Dvikalatra Yoga classes will keep happening. So make notes for all those who are studying. Make notes. It will be helpful. Thank you.